logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, 29 people have tested positive for Zika virus in Rajasthan and the rupee has hit a new low of 74.39 against the dollar. In America, UN Ambassador Nikki Haley has resigned and sponsoring green card for parents will now get tougher. In Punjab, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has laid the foundation stone for a rail coach refurbishing factory in Haryana. And DSTMC President Manjeet Singh GK has not quit his post. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The government has sent experts to try to contain an outbreak of the Zika virus in the popular tourist destination of Jaipur in Rajasthan. 29 people have tested positive. There is no vaccine to the virus, which can cause severe birth defects in unborn children. The rupee slumped by 33 paise to finish at a fresh lifetime low of 74.39 against the US dollar on Tuesday on high crude oil prices, strengthening of the greenback and unabated foreign fund outflows. Traders said that unabated foreign fund outflows weighed on the rupee. The Supreme Court has refused to give urgent hearing to petitions seeking review of its ruling lifting age-old restrictions on procreating women from entering famous Lord Ayyappa temple at Sabarimala in Kerala. It also refused to stay the verdict. Gujarat Congress leader Alpesh Thakor has threatened to shut factories that provide employment to people from outside. His agitation against the rape of a 14-month-old child had triggered attacks on non-Gujaratis in the state. BSP chief Mayawati has said that her party rather fight elections on its own than beg for seats in any alliance. Mayawati last week called off talks with the Congress to fight the upcoming assembly polls in three states together. 9 people were killed and 14 others were injured in gas pipeline blast at the Bhilai steel plant of state-owned SAIL in Chhattisgarh's Durg district. Prime Minister Narendra Modi had in June dedicated the modernized and expanded plant to the nation. The 13,050-foot high Rohtang Pass has been thrown open for tourists. The BRO has cleared the road blocked due to recent snowfall. The pass had been clogged for the past 2 weeks. 3 directors of embattled real estate firm Amrapali Group have been taken into police custody by the Supreme Court. It castigated the company for playing hide-and-seek with the court and not complying with its orders to hand over all the documents to the forensic auditor. The deep depression over the Bay of Bengal has intensified into cyclonic storm Titli. It is moving towards the Odisha Andhra Pradesh coast. The IMD has issued a red alert in Odisha. The raging hashtag MeToo movement has led film association Cinta and IFTDA to react in the wake of sexual harassment allegations against actor Alok Nath and director Vikas Pehal. The Producers Guild of India will form a committee to help the film fraternity to call out and report sexual harassment and abuse. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: US Ambassador to UN Nikki Haley has resigned, marking the latest departure from President Donald Trump's national security circle. President Trump praised the former South Carolina governor for an incredible job and said that he would gladly welcome her back into his administration. A draft proposal of the Trump administration heavily skewed in favor of the wealthy has made it difficult for Indians to sponsor US green card for parents. Green cards can be denied by officials to those with income or financial assets below 250% of federal poverty guidelines. Bilateral trade of goods and services between India and the US has gone up by 119% since 2007, touching $126.2 billion. India is the 9th largest goods trading partner of the US with $74.3 billion in total goods trade during 2017. Hurricane Michael has swiftly intensified into a Category 2 amid fears it would strike Florida on Wednesday as a major hurricane. Mandatory evacuation orders went into effect for some 120,000 people in Panama City Beach. President Donald Trump has apologized to Associate SC Justice Brett Kavanaugh and his family on behalf of the nation for what he called a Democrat-led campaign of lies. The official swearing-in took place on Saturday, but Trump replicated the event in the White House. Economic Development Agency's Overseas Private Investment Corporation is looking to help Indians by partnering and investing in early-stage companies in India. The OPIC operates by providing loan guarantees and other financial products for business projects. The limousine involved in the deadliest transport accident in the US for nearly a decade had failed inspection and the driver was not properly licensed. 20 people were killed when the SUV-style stretch vehicle carried out of control in a New York town. The US has asked Saudi Arabia to support a thorough and transparent probe into the disappearance of dissident Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi. Turkey has concluded that Khashoggi was killed in the Saudi consulate in Istanbul. Internet giant Google is shutting down the consumer version of its own social networking site Google Plus due to low usage. A bug was discovered in March last year that could have leaked the data of about 500,000 of its users. Former President George W. Bush has announced the marriage of his daughter Barbara Pierce Bush to Craig Lewis Coy, a screenwriter and Georgia native, in a private ceremony. Bush was escorted down the aisle by her father and grandfather, former President George H.W. Bush. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Prime Minister Narendra Modi has laid the foundation stone for a rail coach refurbishing factory. He claimed that the project will create employment and boost industrial development in Haryana. It will be set up at a cost of 500 crore rupees. DSGMC President Manjeet Singh GK has said that he had only handed over charge to Senior Vice President Harmeet Singh Kalka and not quit his post. Meanwhile, a senior official claimed that GK had only handed over charge to protest against the stand of his party. On directives of Chief Minister Amrinder Singh, the state declared a public holiday on October 10th on the occasion of Agrasen Jayanti. All offices of government, boards, corporations and educational institutions were closed. The BJP is watching closely and carefully as its oldest ally SED battles with internal issues. Officially, BJP leaders vouch for committed relationship with the SED, but they're waiting and watching for the situation to settle down. Panthic leaders are set to press the leadership to come up with time-bound action by November end. This is after a call was made to observe the third death anniversary of two Sikh youths in the Behbal Kalan police firing incident. Sukhpal Singh Khera-led group of rebel Aam Aadmi Party MLAs have received support for backing Panthic organization's burglary agitation for justice in sacrilege cases. The state party unit is walking a tightrope on the matter. RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat is in Jalandhar on a three-day visit. This is Bhagwat's first major visit after the murders of RSS leaders Brigadier Jagdish Gagneja and Ravinder Gosain. The Education Department has suspended 5 protesting teachers. Government teachers are on an indefinite dharna in Patiala. They're protesting against the Cabinet's decision to regularize the services of 8,800 of them on a monthly basic salary of 15,000 rupees. The centre has appointed 3 members to Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial Trust ahead of preparations for proposed centenary commemoration of Jallianwala Bagh massacre. The trust is headed by the Prime Minister. Comedian Kapil Sharma will be reportedly tying the knot with fiancée Gini Chatrath in December. As per a source, the wedding will be in his hometown Amritsar and preparations have begun. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources. From accounting firms to wedding planners in your city, all of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Actress Sonali Bendre, who is battling cancer, has taken her sickness quite positively and has turned out inspiring many affected souls. While wearing coal, Bendre set out another positive note, one day at a time. She later met veteran actor Anupam Kher, who called her wonderful and refreshing. Sharing images with Bendre, Kher wrote, "The elegance under pressure is the result of fearlessness. It was so wonderful and refreshing to have dinner with the most beautiful, inspiring and courageous Sonali Bendre, along with a compassionate Goldie Belle and ever-smiling Rupa." The Hum Saath Saath Hai actress also met Rishi Kapoor, who is in the US for a medical treatment. Neetu Kapoor shared photographs with Sonali and Priyanka and wrote, "Love you Priyanka Chopra, love you Sonali Bendre, love you Srishti Bell, Goldie, wonderful beautiful people." Well, we hope that Sonali continues to inspire many and gets well soon. Actress Sonakshi Sinha's songs have always been fun and catchy. She previously shared screen with Salman Khan, Dharmendra and Rekha for Rafta Rafta in Yamna Pagla Diwana Firse, and now she will make another unique pair with Ajay Devgan. Ajay and Sonakshi have collaborated for Mungra's song remake. Speaking about the song, Sonakshi said,
"Total dhamal mein hai. Wo jab film release hogi, I think uske kuch din pehle song release hoga. and Mungda ka remake hai, so I'm very, very excited about that. Well, Ajay is there and I'm there, so yeah.
Earlier, Sonakshi posted two photographs on Instagram featuring herself with Ajay. Honored and looking forward to recreate the iconic Mungda with Ajay Devgan, my second song of lovely Helen Aunty this year. Hope she loves it too. Watch out for Total Dhamal in cinemas on 7th December, she wrote alongside the image. Well, the yesteryear's track Picturized on Helen was a hit that people are humming to its tunes even today. Let's see if this Sonakshi Sinha-led song will do equal justice or not. A war of words erupted between contemporaries Sonam Kapoor and Kangana Ranaut when the latter alleged sexual harassment against filmmaker Vikas Bhel. Sonam had reportedly said that sometimes it is difficult to take her seriously, and soon after Kangana retaliated to her comment. Sonam post all this says, "Love is always the answer." Stating her current feelings on Instagram, she wrote, "Women need to stand together. Irresponsible media have misquoted me or taken my quote out of context and made other women react. All I want to say is that all I have is compassion and love for you. I'm proud of where I come from, and so should every other woman or man. Let's stand together and speak up. Let's not pull each other down with bitterness and negativity. Love is always the answer." Now let's see what Kangana has to say about this. Actor Alok Nath, who has been accused of rape by Tara writer-producer Vinta Nanda on Tuesday, said the allegations is absurd as he made her what she is. Alok told ABP News, "Kuch to log kahenge. Neither I am denying this nor do I agree with it. It must have happened, but someone else would have done it. Well, I do not want to talk much about it. As for the matter, if it has come out, it will be stretched. However, we only have to hear to women's stand because they are considered weak." Ayan has tried contacting Alok since Nanda wrote about her experience via a Facebook post on Monday, but calls and messages went unanswered. Nanda, a veteran writer-producer of the 1990s show Tara fame, accused Alok, known for his sanskari on-screen image, of sexually violating her almost two decades ago. The Cine and TV Artists Association has decided to send him a show cause notice. Asked about his sanskari image, Alok said, "What do I have to do with people? People will say anything to spoil the image. Leave my image. Whatever has been said, it is absurd." He said at one point, Nanda used to be his good friend. "Today she said such a big thing. In a way, it was me who made her what she is. It is useless to react on the allegations, as in today's world, whatever a woman says, only that will be considered. In such a situation, it would be wrong to say anything," he said. Nanda held a press conference on Tuesday, talking further about how, when she had opened up two decades ago, nobody came to support her.
"That time when I spoke, not a single person asked me whether that had really happened or not happened. Not a single person questioned him for what he had done. And it was all brushed under the carpet and it was kept aside."
Has she filed a police complaint? Nanda said,
"Did you file a complaint with the police? Did you file a complaint with the police?"
"No."
"Thank you guys.
I have not thought of it. I just told you, मैंने कुछ सोचा नहीं है, मैं सुबह से यही कर रही हूँ."
However, she feels this is just the beginning of the Me Too movement in Bollywood and other fields in India.
"मैंने जो बोलना था मैंने बोल दिया है और इसकी ramifications होंगी. आगे क्या होने वाला है इसको logical end पे ले जाना पड़ेगा. Whether I like it or I don't. Fact is that I have not planned what is going to happen, like I told you earlier. And yes, the perpetrator should be punished, not in my case alone, in every case. And dusra main ye zarur kehna chahungi ki Me Too movement khatam hone ke liye nahi aaya hai. Abhi to shuruaat hai. Me Too movement hamari agli 10 pushton tak ki jo girls and ladies hain unko strengthen karne ke liye aaya hai. Not only that, next generation mein boys bhi no nonsense hain."
Why was she silent for so long?
"I was always working. I left the television industry after my 2-year stint with ZTV. I went on to make my film White Noise, and during the making of that film, I opened up about this particular incident. I spoke about it in a fashion magazine called L'Officiel, in which I personally wrote the whole article, and what I've written on Facebook was written there as well. And subsequently, I had also given an interview to Urvashi Asher of Times of India. It was published in the Times of India that this is what had happened with me. but there was not a murmur about it. Nobody talked about it. Nobody asked me any questions about it. Nobody mentioned it. And there was this air of silence that sustained itself until life went on. And one was like told that good, teaches you a lesson. We told you to keep quiet. You opened your mouth. Kya hua muh kholne ke baad? That is what happened. And then I knew that I had to compartmentalize my life and move on. So I just did that.
Actress Sonakshi Sinha is one actress who easily transitions into different looks, whether it's Dabang's Rajjo or Akira's action avatar. At an event, Sonakshi shared her teenage phase and spoke about her tomboy look.
There was a phase in my teenage years where I went through a very major transformation, I would say. And tabhi mujhe khud mein as in koi interest nahi hota tha, mujhe sports mein zyada interest rehta tha, so I used to never think ki beauty kya hai, khud ko savarna hai, bahar jana hai to kuch earring worry pehno, mujhe kabhi main ye sochti nahi thi. And I was a complete tomboy, so then I stopped thinking ki, you know, ki beauty chhod do. And I think when I started acting, then again that keeda came in.
On professional front, after Happy Fir Bhag Jayegi, Sonakshi was seen in Rafta Rafta song from Dharmendra's film Yamla Pagla Diwana Phir Se. Now, soon she will be seen in a song with Ajay Devgan titled Mungra in his film Total Dhamal, which will also star Madhuri Dixit Nene and Sanjay Dutt in the lead.